Once you've launched your PcVue software, a PcVue screen called Select a Project will display. As you can see, there is a project already created, called Quick Start. This option will help us to create a new project quickly by using one of the templates of screen available. Here, you can change the aspect of your future project. For example, I can change the style, the theme, as well as the number of views depending on my project. For this tutorial, we are going to create a building supervision project, so we will select three views corresponding to three floors. You can easily see the aspect of your future project before generating it by clicking on Test the configuration. I like this aspect, so now we change the title of the views, for example, floor 1, floor 2, and then floor 3. Don't forget to press Enter on the keyboard each time to validate. Then we change the name of the project and generate it. That's it, our project is generated. All we have to do is open PcVue and select it. What we've just done in 2 minutes saved us 2 days of work. Here is PcVue's workspace that contains the graphical elements and all the tools that you'll need to develop a project, including various toolbars. If you don't have the menu, press F6 on your keyboard to display it. Each one of the menus can be dragged and docked to any outside edge of the workspace, or left floating anywhere on the screen. That's very handy for the designer. Now let's open the Application Explorer. The Application Explorer is a handy configuration tool including test and diagnostic features. The communication section defines the way to acquire the data from the field. There are several data acquisition solutions possible in PcVue, including the Industrial Communication Standard, OPC, many native drivers, and specific standard for IEC and DNP3 for energy management systems, or LonWorks and BACnet for building management system. In this tutorial, we are going to connect a device from our building that measures the temperature of a room. This device uses OPC to communicate, so let's create an OPC server. Just select the server that you use for your OPC communication. Then right-click and add an OPC group. Validate. And that's it. Our data acquisition source is now configured. The variable section defines the way the data is organized. It is the core of PcVue containing a set of tags called variables. The variable tree organizes data in a hierarchical manner using a branch structure. For example, to create a real-time database for a simple building management system, you just enter each element of your physical process as a branch. Let's imagine a building and create a new branch. Good. Now, let's define a new branch for a floor in this building. Add a room, for example, the coffee room. And finally, let's create a branch for the heating and air conditioning system. Once the structure is defined, you can add variables. PcVue supports 3 types of variables. Bit for digital value, register for an analog value, and text for a text value. First, we need to create a register value that receives the value of the temperature measured by our device. Let's call it tempval. And as you can see, the register dialog contains specific fields, including unit, format, or mean and max value. Let's put a max of 40 and a mean of 0 for our temperature. As you can see, the register dialog has other configuration tabs, including source, to define the way the value is acquired. Let's select the server that we have created previously. Then we select the group. And we select the ID of our element in this server. The variable is now configured. Now we are going to create another register value to set the temperature that we want from PcVue. To save time, we can easily copy-paste our first variable. Let's change the name for tempSet. And now double-click on the variable to change its properties. As we are going to control the thermostat from the HMI, we must set the command property. It is used to determine whether a variable can be set by PcVue or not. We also need to change the ID of our variable. That's it, our variables are created. It is possible to add a behavior to a variable. Events to trigger a program, an email or a SMS, trends, and thresholds. Let's create thresholds for our variable tempval to trigger an alarm when the temperature measured is too high or too low. Select the type of thresholds, and then select the threshold high and set the value to 22. And select the threshold low and set the value to 18. Here it is, the variable tempval is now configured with two thresholds. Now we need to put an alarm on each threshold. Just double-click on the threshold and select Alarm. The next step is to show how we display the data by setting up drawing elements and animations. First of all, we are going to create a new mimic used as a working mimic. We are now going to create a slider to manage the temperature of our thermostat. In PcVue, you have access to a large library of symbols for many generic and market use. Just click on Insert, Symbol. Symbols are organized in categories. For our project, we need a slider. The second one will do well. Let's insert it. Here, you can see the parameters of the new symbol that we created. We need to connect the animations of the symbol to a variable. To do so, we can select a variable from our database here. Just click on this button and choose the variable TempSet. The symbol is now inserted. Let's switch to Run mode and check if it works. Perfect. We can now create a new text from the Draw toolbar. Just create a text Set to. Then, right-click on the text and you can access to the properties. We can, for example, select a new font as follow. Let's create another text to display the value set by the cursor. To do so, we need to add an animation for this text. We select the animation, text, display register, and we just select the temp set variable. We can also add an adequate format for our temperature. You can have more information about it on the online help section. And that's it. Let's play the animation. It works perfectly. You saw previously that it's easy to switch a mimic from design mode to run mode and back again. It is also possible to duplicate a mimic. Just right-click on the header of the mimic and click on New Window. You can use the copy in a different mode. The same mimic is in design mode on the left and in run mode on the right. Now, let's copy-paste the two texts that we've created. As you can see, the texts are automatically displayed on the other mimic. We are going to change these texts and their animations to display the temperature measured by our equipment in real time. To do so, we are going to open the Graphical Explorer. This tool gives you a quick access to a hierarchical view of all the elements of the mimic. Just double-click on the copy of our first text to access to all its properties in the Graphical Explorer. We are going to change it for Measured Temperature. You can also browse animations from the copy of our second text, and if you double-click on the animation, you can change its properties. Let's choose the variable tempval this time. I like the way it is, so let's drag and drop all our graphics to our Quick Start project. Thanks to the project created from the Quick Start, we already have an alarm screen. Remember that we put the two thresholds as alarms. So let's move the temperature with the cursor and see what happens. You can see that a notification has popped up on the alarm page. Let's click on it. Here is the alarm screen. You can see that there is an alarm because we forced the temperature of our thermostat too low. This alarm viewer displays the status of alarms and is fully customizable, allowing to display any kind of information, such as the threshold value, the user connected, specific contextual attributes values, and so on. It is also possible to acknowledge, mask, and even trigger contextual actions on alarm from this viewer. This is explained in the tutorial on alarms. Let's acknowledge this one. Just click on it and select Hack. As you can see, the notification has gone. Another important screen is already present thanks to the quick start, the Trends screen. Trend Viewer allows to display the trend of real-time value as well as historical value. The trends are already set by default, so we need to change its settings. Just double-click on it when you are on Edition mode. Here, you have access to all the parameters. For our project, it will be interesting to follow the trends of the real-time measured temperature. Let's go on the Curves tab. There are already four local system variables. Let's deactivate them by clicking on this icon. Let's select the variable TempVal. You can also change the color of the curve as well as its aspect. Let's activate the scale by clicking on this icon and then we select AutoFit. This will allow PcVue to adapt the scale to the curve. Now go on Advanced Curves to set the threshold lines. Click on this button and just select Auto. We want to have the threshold lines, so just select Draw the threshold lines. Here we go, we now have the trends for our measured temperature. That's it for this tutorial. Now you have the basics to create a full connected project in less than 15 minutes with PcVue.